another update on the ongoing progress of the work on the layout. Here in front of you see the entrance to the Railport Logistics Depot. We've been adding along the back there, against the wall, some of the scenic scatter. With basically used Woodland Scenics earth undercoat paint and fine earth turf along the edge there. And basically we've done that all the way down to the bottom end down there. In that recess over in the top corner will eventually be the town scene. So we've now got to basically add vegetation, bushes and weeds and bits and bobs on there, and also was it a retaining wall and a back seam. In front of you here is the front part of the Railport Logistics Depot, and we've now added the road surface yard markings, and we've tried to do a bit of weathering along the rails. So if I just pull the wagons out of the way, give you a better idea. So basically we've tried to make it mucky between the rails and alongside, and for the gridded area we've used the stencils, road marking stencils. It's a kit from bothrowithscenery.com. I'll put the links down below, and basically it covers this kit virtually most of or all the UK road markings that you'll find currently out there at the moment. Basically it's like a stencil, you just overlay, and with a sponge you just basically dab over the stencil, and you end up getting this weathered sort of look here. If you just do it a bit like dry brushing, and this is the kind of effect you'll get. So in front of you here, we're looking at the basically the back of the Railport distribution depot and the perimeter fence, and you can see we've now added some of the palisade fencing. That is actually a laser cut card kit, again from modelrailwayscenery.com, and it also comes complete with a set of gates which you can see there. Also by the same company is this laser cut orange safety barriers, and I think the kit makes up about 16 barriers, so we've just sort of put them around that part of the yard there to make a bit of a truck park. As I said in the previous update, we'll be adding a gatehouse on the entrance there as well. Now if you look to the other side of the orange barriers there in front of the Eddie Stobart shed, you see where the two figures are stood. We've now got some safety railing, again it's from modelrowerscenery.com, and this is laser cut plastic, and he offers two types of modern UK safety barriers. So I'll show you in a minute some close up still pictures to give you a better idea. One of the other things we've been doing as well is, if we just slowly pan back around to the fuel storage point there, is that we've added another retaining wall across the front part of the where the storage tanks are, and we've added a set of access ladders to go over the top. And the barbed wire that you can see there, that comes from Javis, and basically the outside perimeter of the property runs along there and about halfway down, hence why we've got all the barbed wire on the top. But so I've run the barbed wire right to the edge there, so if any of the thieving little wee people were to try and climb over the fence and try to use the path of the retaining wall behind the perimeter, it'll make their job just a little bit more difficult trying to get over. So I'll show you as I say shortly, some close-up still pictures of that. So if I just pan the camera back across again, you can see again with some of these was it road markings from that road stencil kit I've just previously mentioned. So we've done like with the double white line across the front, the yellow safety walkway line which goes there and then runs along to the entrance of the main building there, with the speed limit signs and also the loading bays, which they have the numbers, and the parking bay signs. So in front of you here, looking at the loading bay, you can see with the bays that we've painted, and what I've also done is at these points here we've put four yellow marker dots, and these are basically for the tracked units for when the driver's reversing in, that the rear two axles, once they line up with them yellow dots, know that they're back in far enough. The other thing we've done, if I just slowly turn the camera around, is that on this truck here and this one here, we've had the cabs open, and that we've added some of the weave folks with the drivers there, and these are basically a pack of driving figures from NOC. So the other thing you can see here now is that we've added lighting to two of the buildings here, and we've used basically the white light LEDs and also the warm light LED. The warm light is on the Eddie Stoback building on the left there, and that's from Model Lighting Solutions. Again, I shall put the link down below. Discussing this morning with my friend Duncan from Scotland. Hi Duncan. We're on about having with some more yard lighting to go in on here, is that as Duncan's mentioned, having like a single gantry light that has about six lights on the top for basically doing the whole yard. So we'll have a look at trying to get one custom made basically to fit over in sort of the corner over on the right hand side there to light the whole yard up. So as mentioned on the previous update, as regards to the lighting on this small distribution depot centre on this other corner of the layout here, Kilbracken Distribution, is that we said we were going to add another light. Or you see now that we've added one in the corner here, and again this is from Model Lighting Solutions, and it's one of the warm lights, so you can see the difference between the two with the cooler white light and the warmer white light there. So moving back to the rail port again, with the yard overhead crane, you can see here that we've also fitted another one of these surface mount LED lights on the crane, and basically run the wires down the front of it. I still need to paint the red wire just to try and hide it and blend it in, and just add some dummy wires to like some electrical type switch box as well, just to give it a bit more detail. So with the lights now off on the depot, you can see now we've had a go at trying to weather and make as though the barrels look as though they're seeing a little bit of service. And the other thing we've been adding is this access ladder for the roof of the distribution depot. And again, this is from modelroadscenery.com, and it's the laser cut ladder. The ladder comes as a flat pack that you cut out and can be extended up to a reasonable height. So if you've got say like tall fuel tanks, storage tanks on your depot or the like, then these ladders will be absolutely perfect for that. As I say, have a look on their website at the Layouts Club members page, and you can see some photographs that somebody has done just that. So in front of you here, by Black Rock Cottage, you can see that we've added some more little scenic details. The first being is the post box on the post. Found that in my scenics box, completely forgotten about that. Not sure who made that. If I remember, I'll post the link below. And to the right of that, you can see a small post, yellow post, and on the back fence there you can see two more little posts there, and they was it concrete marker posts for utilities like water, electric cables, gas and fire hydrant and stuff. So you can see with the second post along from the post box, that's a yellow fire hydrant. Again, it's from the same company, modelroadscenery.com, who incidentally did the fencing here as well. It's basically a laser cut kit, so it's a case of just cutting out, painting and sticking the label on and just gluing onto the layout. It's one little detail item you don't really tend to see on many layouts, so I'm quite pleased that he's actually brought these out. The next thing I'll have to do now is to put some kind of a manhole cover somewhere in front of the fire hydrant. In front of you here you see an Oxford diecast Network Rail Ford Transit van with two Batman Scenecraft figures. They're the track workers pack. I don't know if that pack is still current now, but I'm sure they'll be floating around on eBay or wherever. However, with this van we've added a few little scenic extra bits, and that being is the roof bars, the roof mounts, two sets of triple ladders, and on the rear door was it mounts and the ladder on the back there to gain access so the wee folk can pull the ladders off the roof. Again, I shall post links down below. Well, I think on, as mentioned earlier on in this update, with the safety barriers, here's some more. You can see, I think they go very well across the entrance there to the station. And over on the right hand side here, if I just slowly pan the camera around, you can see some more of these orange safety barriers that you see in factories and roadworks and various other places as well. Again, that is a laser cut card which you basically you just paint up orange, the feet black, stick the feet on and then just basically cut out and glue in place the red and white reflective marker. So over here behind the fuel storage tanks on the railport depot, you can see we've now added some trees there. There was just some cheap ones I found at a swap meet time train fair. While I think on at some point to the right there in that recess is that we'll be looking at adding the was it fueling point for the trucks for the depot. Now moving on to the next part of the layout, which we've been doing a lot of work on this past week, is the incline, and we've now added the retaining walls on both sides, as well as the basically the bare bones foundation for what will be a road that will be running down in front of it. And as you can see here, going down into Kilbreck tunnel down there. However, what we've done with these retaining walls is because these two baseboards at the back are removable, the retaining walls have to be removable. So from that section there, there's actually a break in the wall, and this part of the wall is glued onto that baseboard, whereas that part there and along here, they're actually velcroed in place. I know a few of you others have used this method. So as you can see here, I'll just show you on this one. There you go. And that all allowed me to gain access with the first set of points and second set of points in the fiddle yard here. The road, we're going to make a single track, passing place, part way on it somewhere. But the road, as it comes down, will sort of curve off the scene down here. And then we need to be looking at some kind of a board or something just to fill in the gaps here. I've made it so that the ramp can be quickly unscrewed and removed off, thus gaining more easy access to the back. And the bit that's sitting above the tunnel, this bit here, that is completely freestanding. There's two like little guides I've put behind for the two legs to sort of sit in. Again, that is removable for me to gain access to the rear part of the layout there underneath. So the next thing I need to do now on this section is on this retaining wall, is on that side. I need to just add some like weathering earth dirt, which we've done on the back wall there, and add in a bit more vegetation, like weeds and bushes and things, and some more cable trunking. Now with the cable trunking, we're going to use, again from modelrailwayscenery.com, is the laser cut one, and this build makes up 143 centimetres of trunking and includes 8 T-junctions, as it clearly states there. So if we just turn it over, so as you can see here, this is how it comes, and you basically just cut out the very fine pips and it just pops out, and you just basically glue it together. It all comes with the instructions, and very straightforward. So in the next update I should have that done and installed in there. So thanks for watching, stay tuned, and there'll be more to come. Bye for now.